Mr. Chairman, thank you very much for the presentation. And also I would like to thank the organizing committee of the workshop for inviting me here, giving me the opportunity to discuss with you some current research that we do in collaboration with Professor Chrysoula Tsoga and Yannis Petromichalakis in the Foundation of Research and Technology in Crete. Our research, it is in very preliminary stage. So I could say that I mainly come here in order to bring some messages rather than present an entire methodology. So the outline of my presentation is composed by three parts. The first part giving some definitions, then some mechanisms that are hidden behind the whole formulation, and finally some examples with some further remarks. So we will discuss about a procedure called time reversal, which actually it is better described as an observation made by originally from by Matthias Fink in France in laboratory experiments. And at the beginning, for taking into account acoustic mediums, but also it is applicable in elastic waves, including both compression and shear waves. Also, the time reversal procedure has been extended to consider a computational tool for solving some class of inverse wave or vibration problems. And that is what we are interested to here, to inverse problems. Inverse problems in order to define sources localized on some structure, or better, even better, to define, localize, and sometimes to define the geometry of defects, damage in structures. Time reversal procedure, it seems to be a continuously active field, as we can also see from this given review articles of the last decade or even 15 years. Applications of this procedure, mainly as I have already said, are for problems of source identification or scatter defect identification. Any defect may in wave propagation, any defect might serve as a scatterer, where we have some discontinuity of the incident waves there. Problems that have been researched are of hydrodynamics, electromagnetism, acoustic, and elastodynamics. Field of applications are such medicine, telecommunications, underwater acoustics, geophysical applications as seismology and epicenter, for example, epicenter localization, noise reduction, and non-destructive test. So the setup of our problem. We assume a medium omega under given boundary and initial conditions. We also think of some subdomain of it, omega s, where excitation is applied, and the second subdomain, omega r, where sensors are present there and record response in time. Intersection of these two subdomains might be non-empty. The medium omega might be heterogeneous, embedding a number of scatterers, and to be of complicated geometry. The time reversal process is defined both in time domain and in frequency domain. We will focus here in time domain, so I will just mention that in frequency domain we can find it in the literature as phase conjugation process. Now, in time domain, the time reversal process, it is a two-step procedure. First, an input signal. Let's see here. We have the forward and the backward procedure. Due to the forward procedure, we send from some points, excitation points, excitation, for example, pulses or in general, the transient defined forces, and we record the response only in some part of the domain for a certain duration of time. Now, in the backward process, we send back what it was recorded in this on these sensors, but reversed in time. And we claim that in some specific time, which actually is equal to the duration time, the wave field will have a concentration on the source. This is also called refocusing. Ideal conditions are the conditions that the subdomain where response is recorded will be coincide with the entire domain, and also no noise in the measurements of the response would exist. However, remarkably, time reversal procedure does not need ideal conditions in order to work, and also is shown to work better when there is a lot of multiple scattering into the domain. Just because with a lot of scatterers we have too many reflected waves, and in such a way we have more information recorded on our recorders. The forward process is supposed to be performed physically in the field, is what we record in some structure, and backward process is to be done computationally. The mathematical model of source identification, the forward and the backward model. We have the equation of motion for elastic wave propagation, under some boundary conditions and initial conditions, with some sources located just on the domain that we have the excitation. For this reason, we use the delta function there. Then we record on some other part and we send back the reverse in time signal. In order to solve problems of damage identification, we work instead of the original field with the scatter field. As we know, the scatter field, some scatterer will send back, will scatter the original wave field. So we may assume that it is a secondary source. Having a procedure to define sources, in this way we may define also the scatterer, its location, the response in time, and in some other cases also the geometry of the scatterer. In case that we have many scatterers, many defects, we need some norm in order to give us, to provide us the time that we need to make this imaging, to see where the scatterer is, where the defect is. Here we use the bounded variation norm defined in the literature, and it given us as an appropriate norm in order to use it for such problems where we have concentration of the wave field. Having multiple defects, we take from the literature methodology. It is called DORT, are the initials of some French terms that I don't know exactly because I don't speak French, but it is we assume to have a domain where for with some sensors and some defects. From each sensor we send a pass, then a defect starts to emit in later time a secondary source. This is the scattered field. The traces are recorded at all sensors. In the backward propagation, we send back what it was recorded on these sensors, and we expect to have first a focusing on the scatter, on the defect, and later on the source. Using the above technique, we are able to construct the response matrix, which is a nth order matrix, and we need it in order to perform a Fourier transform on this, then to perform the singular value decomposition of this Fourier transform response matrix to define the neither number and the number singular values and respective vectors. We perform inverse Fourier transform, and then we time reverse and re-emit signals, solving numerically the equation of motion using the bounded value norm. We localize defects. Now, we said that we also need to solve the wave propagation problem numerically. Numerical solutions of wave propagation in elastic or acoustic medium could be done with an appropriate numerical method, as for example, finite element method and boundary element method, among others. For conventional finite element method, and for the case of time-dependent boundary conditions that needed to be imposed, we may utilize special techniques that exist in the literature. Also, we need to comment here that mixed formulations of finite element method in combination with explicit time discretization schemes for wave propagation problems prove to be very accurate as well as very efficient and fast, and have been utilized in this work. All the numerical examples that are given here have been accomplished using in-house software developed by our team. So let's go to the examples with a first simple problem, which is a truss structure, a bridge-like, let's say, structure, where we have in some point a source and just one other point where we record the response. Numerical solution has been done with conventional finite elements integrated in time with the beta numeric method. For the backward problem, we assume given forces rather than imposition of displacements. Here is the pulse that we send from the source, and also at the correct time the distribution in the space of the magnitude of displacements, which will give us also the peak of it, will give us, will provide us with the location of the source. We can see it better having the image at this specific time step, where we can see that the position of the source, we have a concentration of the wave field. Then, and since we are, we consider problems of elastic dynamics, we need to play with time. So it's better to see some motion, some movies in time. For a problem of two-dimensional elastic dynamics, we consider here a square. We have an array of sensors. We send from the central sensor some pulse. We also have a defect. It is located there on the right. And we will try to localize this defect. First, we see the wave field of the scattered wave because of the pulse sent by the sensor, the central sensor. Everything here is recorded on the array of sensors that are with green points here. Up to some moment, we need to pass from the sensor here. This is the last time point. Then we will backpropagate what we have recorded. We will also use the L1 or the bounded value norm in order to define the time that we will make the image and to see where is the defect localized, which here is the last slide. But we see what it is sent back, the propagation of the wave, going back. We also see some, I hope you can see there, some small black dot, which is here. Here is the black dot. Here is the defect. And we can see that the wave field refocuses there. Then, in order to see problems of multiple defects, we use now an acoustic medium, not an elastodynamic one. So we have a scalar quantity. And we have, it's the geometric configuration is more or less the same, but we have two defects. One here and another one larger down there. We will send from all pulses from all these elements of the array, but we will just see some movie sending from this central array. And then we will use this procedure with the singular bio decomposition method in order to localize two specific defects, to localize each defect by itself. Here is the scattered field because of the two defects. It is different because they are different in size. And we once again record everything on our array. Then, here are the singular values in the plotted with frequencies, and we claim that each the non-zero singular values will provide us with the position of each scatterer. And other, we know that we have two scatterers, two defects, so we are. We expect that for these two first non-zero singular values, we will have focus on these defects. other non-zero values might be some interaction between them or just noise. Projecting on the first singular vector and sending back, we may see that the wave field directs to the first, or better saying, to the larger defect. While projection on the second singular vector will provide us with the location of the second defect, which is here. So, summarizing, we presented the time reversal methodology with some applications of it, the numerical implementation of it with some appropriate numerical method, and we presented some examples. Further, a lot of work is needed. We are in very primary state, and we would like to consider earthquake loading, ambient and service loads, excitation environment, accounting for dispersion and damping, which any real structure has, and then to apply this method to actual structural health monitoring problems with a focus on already sensored on-field structures, such as bridges. And let me tell you that some in the literature, some publication of a specific application on bridges, I think somewhere in the US or in Canada, but I'm not sure, exist. Thank you very much for your attention.